converting child outcomes data to OSEP progress categories and summary statements. In this presentation, you will learn how the data on child outcomes that local early intervention and early childhood special education programs collect are transformed into the national data reported by the U.S. Department of Education's Office of Special Education Programs, OSEP. For each child who participates in early intervention or early childhood special education for at least 6 months, the state must report data on three outcomes when the child exits the program. The three outcomes are: children have positive social-emotional skills, including social relationships. Children acquire and use knowledge and skills, including early language, communication, and early literacy. Children use appropriate behaviors to meet their needs. The state agency collects this information from all programs around the state. To demonstrate how this information is converted into the numbers that are sent to the U.S. Office of Special Education Programs, let's start with the progress reporting categories. There are five progress reporting categories, each representing progress between entry and exit. When reporting progress data, states identify the percentage of children who: A. did not improve functioning. B. improved functioning but not sufficient to move near to functioning comparable to same age peers. C. improved functioning to a level near to same age peers but did not reach it. D. improved functioning to reach a level comparable to same age peers. And E. those who maintained functioning at a level comparable to same age peers. The progress reporting categories can also be thought of as different developmental trajectories. In this graph, age in months is shown across the bottom. Five different trajectories of growth in an outcome are illustrated with different colored lines. Look at the red line in the graph. This illustrates the first reporting category, A, which refers to children who did not show any improvement in functioning between entry and exit. The purple line illustrates typical development and is category E, children who continue to function like same age peers between entry and exit. The green line shows category D, children who were not functioning like same age peers in the outcome when they entered the program, but caught up and were functioning like same age peers by the time they left the program. Both the blue and orange lines illustrate the growth of children who were not functioning like same age peers when they entered the program. The orange line shows children who begin to acquire skills at a faster rate after entering the program at around 24 months. The blue line represents children who continue to acquire new skills at the same rate after they enter the program. Note that the red line is flat between 12 and 66 months. All other lines go up, indicating that these children acquired new skills over time. There is one more thing to be aware of to understand how the national data on child outcomes are calculated. The national data are reported in two summary statements, which are derived from the numbers in each of the A to E reporting categories. The first summary statement is: of those children who entered or exited the program below age expectations in each outcome, the percent who substantially increased their rate of growth by the time they turn 3 years of age, or for preschool by the time they turn 6, or exited the program. The shorthand for this summary statement is children who showed greater than expected growth. You can see from the formula that summary statement 1 is calculated by adding the children in categories C and D and dividing that number by the sum of the number of children in categories A, B, C, and D. In this example, 75% of children who entered the program below age expectations and social relationships increased their rate of growth by the time they exited the program. Summary statement 2 is: the percent of children who were functioning within age expectations in each outcome by the time they turned 3, or 6 for preschoolers, years of age, or exited the program. Summary statement 2 is calculated by adding the number of children in categories D and E and dividing that number by the total number of children across all categories. This summary statement is often described as children who exited the program within age expectations. For the same example, 54% of children who exited the program were functioning within age expectations in social relationships. Now, when you see a table like this, you will know how the local data on child outcomes became the national data reported about early intervention and early childhood special education.